Honorable Chairperson, Professor Pandey, Chief Guest, Professor Mishra, Honorable Vice Chancellor, Kailash Sir, the dignitaries in the dais, distinguished guest, and all the colleagues, Namaste. I am pleased to be here with all of you as the keynote speaker of this first National Conference on Sociology. I am grateful to the organizer for this honor. Tracing out the archaeology of modern social sciences route, one would reach in the Western intellectual tradition, interacting, collating, and cooperating with natural sciences. Life sciences, etc., and social sciences are evolving and producing new streams, sub-streams, and their applied fields. In this context, sociology, an organic discipline, was also evolved in the West to study modern societies, cleavages, conflict, cooperation, coordination, etc. However, by its inherent own of the core additive values, new forms of knowledge structures are creating and recreating across various points of the history, incorporating other disciplines' proposals too. Thus, these days, sociology includes various typologies and subfields. Similarly, its constitutive natures and components are reshaping dynamism in interacting with non-Western intellectual traditions. Therefore, I am proud to say that a dialogue held in this type of academic gathering of more than 200, I counted as, has a universal significance in the process of production and distribution of knowledge in human society. Such gatherings where sociologists gather and deliberate on a wide range of issues, most prominently including the nature and dynamics of society, can be highly important for providing well-substantiated inputs for Nepal's future sociology. Sociology and its practitioners could bring in the experience of similar societies as similar junctures of history to throw light upon the predicament that Nepal currently undergoing, as also to suggest a pathway that values both democracy and equity. Like social institutions, academic disciplines also emerge, grow and get the stage of maturity through a process of change. Among such changes are an expansion and a further specialization of intellectual engagement and a redrawing of the borders of the respective domains of knowledge. Within the last 3.5 decades of history, sociology discipline, as practiced within a university setting, has entered several transitions. The teaching of sociology, together with that of anthropology, first began in Nepal in 1981. For several years, most of the courses taught were common to both of these disciplines in one department, with blending in one syllabus more or less since its inception. Not that the two disciplines upheld two distinctive traditions and the fields of operation, the students on a degree of sociology or anthropology, we have achieved much more in this short time period and in terms of teaching tradition, and gradually sociology has become one of the popular subjects within the social sciences. We can measure its popularity through its classes. Almost every major constitutional college of the Tribhuvan University have started sociology discipline inside and outside Kathmandu Valley. During subsequent years, the distinctives of the two traditions took further root in both teaching and research. In both sociology and anthropology, specialized streams and courses gradually took hold. Specialized optional courses were introduced fairly rapidly. Areas of research also became more distinctive. This process has, for several years now, culminated to a stage where all of the courses at the master level as well as at the MPhil level have become mutually distinctive and independent. This process leads one to believe that the academic prosperity of both of the disciplines will advance further, like in most other universities of the world, by encouraging them to operate under independent management. This process helps the two disciplines to further sharpen their theoretical orientation, methodological tools, as well as the empirical space that in turn may lead to a further enhancement to our understanding of the nature and the dynamics of social relations. I believe that this gathering of social and professional is a result of the intellectual interest for promoting distinctive and independent identity of the disciplinary tradition. The search of a separate identity through specialization of professional commitment, however, poses both opportunities and challenges for a community of intellectuals. At one level, this process opens a novel niche for engagement into research and intellectual discourses. At another level, it obliges sociology and policy to anchor empirical information in distinctly theoretical frameworks under traditions. For the students of sociology of Nepal, the ongoing process of transformation of society provides one excellent niche both for empirical and theoretical research as well as for pedagogical purposes. Now we are in between two biggest populous countries, China and India, which are emerging big economies of the world. We all are predicting that the next century will be Asia's century, as Japan has remained third world's economy. Japan is also one of the best natural sciences knowledge producers in the world. Asia includes world's oldest renowned historical civilization. Thus, we would predict that military, economic, as well as intellectual powers would gradually shift in the Asia. Consequently, this region will be able to produce new theories, methodologies and practices embedded with its tradition, culture and old ways. These days, in China and India, a discourse had been erupted through the analogy yoga. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi claims yoga connects human being with natural order, respectively as alternative body of knowledge have been proposed. These notions are embedded with a Taoism and a Sanatana Dharma tradition. These knowledges have proposed a continuum of human and nature system against a dichotomy between subjects versus objects. Now, non-Western sociologists, scientists are exploring alternative knowledge system through mutual cooperation and exploration, excluding the Western American tradition as philosophy, provide the cognitive apparatus that gives individuals a space to orient themselves in the world. This toolkit consists of a multiplicity of cultural and ideational elements, which include beliefs, ceremonies, artistic forms, and informal practices such as language, conversation, stories, daily rituals. Nepal, a locus of political tumult, has been a seething cauldron of significant, robust, rapid change on its recent history. Nevertheless, technocratic political alteration, autocratic Rana rule, multi-party polity with kingship, partyless panchayat regime, constitutional monarchical multi-party system, and the abolition of the monarchy have been engaged since 1950. In the conduits of this political transformation, Nepal is enduring rapid and massive social and cultural changes or shifting. Since 1990, particularly the post-Maoist insurgency, various forms of activism and social movements are replacing the role of political parties, somehow overcoming shared political ideologies, socialism, liberalism, and democracy, with sparse social makers. Marcos, ethnicity, caste, region, religion, etc. are in the center of discourse. Mala Madesh chahiyo, mala Janajati Rajesh chahiyo, mala Phalana chahiyo. However, it is a global phenomenon and has been especially in Nepal building a consensus of a new ideology. On 20th May 2008, Nepal turn into a republic state, abolishing one of the oldest monarchies of the world. The Antony Constitution of Nepal 2007 is erected on the outcomes of a massive street movement across Nepal. At the premium of the Constitution, locate the movements in the center or to restructure the country progressively for the revolution of resolution of the class, ethnic, regional, and gender-related problems prevailing in the country is keeping with people's mandate and aspiration expressed frequently in various historical struggles and movements since before 1951 in favor of democracy, peace, and progression. However, yet we are struggling to promote a new political constitution addressing social and cultural constitution of Nepalese people. Sociologists should have the capacity to meet all these challenges, developing own Nepali theory and methods. There are so many problems that we have to face. But in the absence of significant national budget for the social sciences in Nepal, researchers are unable to develop their own research subject, proper methodology, methods. Academics are often engaged in class in research agenda provided by others. Social Science Research Council, हाम्रो देशमा चाहिन्छ भनेर अहिले हामीले लागिराखेका छौँ. सोसल इन्क्लुजन रिसर्च फन्ड जुन नर्वेजियन फन्ड थियो त्यसलाई अगाडि बढाएर अहिले महिला बालबालिका मन्त्रालयबाट सोसल साइन्स रिसर्च काउन्सिल एज ए थिङ्क ट्याङ्कको रूपमा नेपालमा रहनुपर्छ भनेर हामी भिडिराखेका छौँ र सबै हाम्रा समाजशास्त्री मानव साथी साथी जो हुनुहुन्छ उहाँहरूको हामीलाई सहयोग चाहिएको छ कि नेपालले सोसल साइन्स रिसर्च काउन्सिल राख्नुपर्दछ कि गभर्मेन्टले जुन बजेट छुट्याएको छ त्यो रिसर्चको लागि एकदम नगण्य र केही पनि छैन भन्दा हुन्छ. मेरो अलि लामो छ, सुन्नु होला. On the other hand, as noted earlier, Nepal has been a witness to significant, robust and rapid, as I mentioned before, political shiftings in 1950. Through the conduits of this political transformation, Nepal is enduring rapid and massive social and cultural change, as I mentioned before. Since 1990, particularly the post-Maoist insurgency, various forms of activism and popular movements have been replaced the role of political party. Rajnitik party bhanda अब यो जनजातिहरूको भयो, यसरी मुस्लिमहरूको भयो, अनि मधेसको भयो, अनि हामीलाई एक मधेस प्रदेश चाहियो, अनि हाम्रो जाने दार्चुलादेखि इलामसम्म जाने अर्को राज्य चाहियो, ती जातिले भोइसेस लाइक द्याट. द ट्रेडिसनल फर्म्स अफ पोलिटिकल आइडियोलोजी सोसियलिजम लिबरलिजम एन्ड डेमोक्रेसी हेभ बिन सम हाउ अपेन्डेड रिफाइन द कन्सियसनेस टु बिल्ड न्यू आइडियोलोजिज कास्ट इथनिसिटी रिलिजन टु नेम ए फ्यु. दिस पोलिटिकल एन्ड सोसल चेन्जेस हेभ स्प्रङ various potential and pertinent issues of to re-register such as issues of state, nation, democracy, nationalism, federalism, caste, ethnicity, social exclusion and social inclusion to list a few. Social researchers are facing serious challenges to study the evolved political notions and social cultural landscape. Similarly, non-Western academics have been attempted to represent their theory and methodology in the social science world. Therefore, it is obvious that the changes undergoing in Nepalese society can be interpreted at multiple levels of its structure. At the macro level, society is itself a singular structure comprised of a number of constituent elements. These elements, following Parsons' formulation, can broadly be classified into four major categories of its subsystems. One of these subjects include that aspect of society which perform the tasks are required for enabling it to adapt with or survive in existing social environment. Secondly, another subset of society is the one which bears the responsibility of setting its institutional goals and facilitating their procedures followed by the attainment of these goals. The normative regulation prescribed for the maintenance of integrity in the relationship among units of the system constitute the third subcomponent of the society. There is also the fourth category of this subsystem which incorporates those social units that take responsibility for maintaining the continuity of the pattern of this social relation. यसको लागि हामीले पार्सलको राम्रोसँग पढ्नुहोस्, पछि थाहा हुन्छ, धेरैले थाहा पनि होला. The subsystem that enables society to adapt its environment incorporates its economic institutions. As economy involves a number of events and activities which relate to ownership and the use of resources, management of production processes, use of products and its distribution practices. Historically, economic system have undergone through the gradual process of change in all social settings. An improvement of technological means, incremental size of a given population growth, of market and transformation of policy regulation contribute to introduce change in the features of an economic system. With the past few decades, the features of economic system in Nepal have been changing very, very rapidly. The number of population depending in agriculture is sharply decreasing. अब कृषि बाटो के त भने भिन्न हुन थाल्यो गाउँका खेतहरु सब बारेहरु सब बाँझो देखिन थालेछ सब्सिस्टेन्स सेक्टर अफ द इकोनोमी कनेक्टेड इज कनेक्टेड विथ द मार्केटिङ अराउन्ड कमोडिटी मार्केट इज पेनेट्रेटिङ भेरी हेभिली इन बोथ प्रडक्सन एन्ड डिस्ट्रिब्युसन सेक्टर्स अफ इकोनोमिक एक्टिभिटी लेबर फोर्स अफ द कन्ट्री इज हाइली कनेक्टेड विथ द फोर्स अफ ग्लोबल इकोनोमी अब कसरी चाहिँ हाम्रा एउटा गल्फ कन्ट्रिजहरूमा मलेसियामा काम गर्न गइरहेको छ यसको लागि हाम्रो विज्ञवन्त भाइ डाक्टर गणेश गुरुङ उहाँले भन्नु होला यसको बारेमा त्यो यसरी लेबर फोर्स गइरहेको अवस्था छ दुई जना अदर सच चेन्जिङ इकोनोमिक फिचर अफ सोसाइटी हेभ मेड एन इम्प्रेसिभ इम्प्याक्ट अल्सो इन अदर फर्म्स अफ सोसल रिलेसन द इम्प्याक्ट क्यान बी फाउन्ड इन दि प्याटर्न्स अफ रिलेसनसिप एमङ मेम्बर्स अफ डोमेस्टिक युनिट्स लोकल कम्युनिटिज एन्ड इन दि वर्किङ अफ ट्रेडिसनल इन्स्टिट्युसन लाइक किनसिप म्यारिज and families. Now, Sociologist of Nepal, Sociologist of Nepal have to undertake the responsibility for the exploration and analysis these aspects of change in society that you have to reelect. Like in economic institutions, the changes can be observed also in the political space of society. Political institutions represent their component of a social system which set its institutional goals and implement them into action. The state is the principal form of political institution which performs this act through the control and exercise of coercive power of society. However, the state is not a monolithic unit. It takes multiple forms and it is comprised of a number of executive, legislative, as well as judiciary organs distributed at multiple layers of its organization settings. The form of state may range between monarchy, oligarchy, and polyarchy. The features of these specific forms of the state affect the way through which it exercises its power in society. Within the history of modern Nepal, Nepali state has undergone through a number of transformations between these multiple forms. It changed between absolute monarchy, absolute oligarchy, multi-party type of constitutional monarchy, and a polyarchic type of democratic republic. During the course of these transitions, the relation of the state with the people appeared at occasion in the form of a silence of terror from coercion. Conflict for search of right over domination and euphoric anarchy of excessive enjoyment of civil and political rights by the population under a weak state in the period of its transition. A lot of things are there. With the introduction of multi-party type of political practices, the political power of the country is not concentrated on the institution of the state alone. Rather, it is diffused in multiple forms of political organization, open even outside in formal structure. These institutions on the one hand include those party-based organizations that operate through holding some national agenda. At others, there has been an upsurge also of caste, ethnicity, gender, region, and religion-based organizations that put pressure on the state of safeguard of the right of their respective communities within its political and economic structures. The upsurge of demands of these multiple forms of identity-based organization has posed a question on the legitimate prevailing structure. Consequently, the dominant debate on politics of the present day Nepal is concentrated on the issues of restructuring. The debate of federal framework of state and the distribution of power between its federal units have their own specific kind of political significance. At the same time, it is equally important to identify an appropriate process of redistribution of power among different categories of social and regional units located even within each province. Within the period of more than half a decade in the past, the political effort of the country is concentrated towards identifying the appropriate framework of its federal structure and the process of redistribution of power. It is geared to institutionalize this process of change through making it in the provision of constitution of the nation, however, political actors of the country, have found a common ground, comprised to lead this process of towards a logical end. Samadhan Raja Sambhav Samiti, as even the common ground for the exercise get a hakucha, Raja Puna Samadhan Kosarika. The absence of agreement among political organizations locating the features of federal structure should not be understood only at the level of its face value of their differential arguments. Rather, it is a problem embedded in the structure of society at which each of these organizations represent the interest of a specific category of the population. These categories reflect in the forms of caste, sometimes on the basis of caste, region, religion, and gender-based division of its population. Asia has to get the will of the, all these categories of the people and incorporate it in the state politics. The relation between the state and its population is a dynamic phenomenon. It is historically constructed. Any change in the feature of the state or a change in the interest of its population demands for a change in the structure of relation between them. We have experienced that introduction of the liberal form of plural democracy in a unitary state is not a sufficient condition to maintain political stability of the society that we observe. At the same time, the experience of India among our neighbors provides the example that the stability of federal units also depend upon the extent with which they can introduce a feeling of anarchy among people. Statecraft involves a close reading of the changing relationship between the state itself and its citizens. Drafting constitution and the laws and making policies demands is a close reading of the nature of this dynamism. Now, sociologists can help in all these endeavors. The government therefore has to enlist the help of the professional sociologists on a much more expanded basis. In the absence of compromise among political actors about the physical structure of the state, the strength of the provisions of law and other normative standards of society is also gradually weakening. Almost every day, one can encounter with the news of such events like bribery, robbery, rape.
अब आइतको जन समस्याहरु देखिएको छ फलाना ठाउँमा बलात्कार भयो फलाना ठाउँमा हत्या भयो फलाना ठाउँमा जन घुसखोरी भयो यस न हो सच सोशल क्राइम्स ह्यापनिङ इन डिफरेंट पार्ट्स अफ द कंट्री देशभरिकै त गभर्नमेन्ट उही भएको हुनाले अहिले त्यो खालको जन कन्ट्रोल हुन सकेको छैन.
Part of these problems may originate on the asymmetry between the scale of individual expectation and availability of earning opportunity among people in the face of changing structure of adaptive organ of society, for example, in the its economy. Much importantly, it may relate also on weakened performance of the role played by different institutions of the state. The changes in economic, political, and normative components of society do indicate that there must have been some changes also on socialization pattern. Socialization pattern means the parivartan ne unuparto. Jastai family structure and the moral values related to relationship among the members of such institutions like kinship, marriage, and domestic units. In the past few decades, there has been an impressive expansion of educational institutions in the country. Such growth of educational institutions together with exposure of people with changes in other institutions of society have contributed to upgrade the level of awareness of members of its society. However, there is a remarkable distinction in the modalities of this exposure and their effects among different categories of the population. The community of sociology professional has the responsibility to work on enhancing our knowledge. These changes of an analogy, causes and concerns of different effects. There is a problem. I mean, some of the root cause of the problem. Indeed, sociology as an academic discipline emerged as a result of scholarly interest towards understanding the social process that contribute to maintain a given order of society or to introduce some level of change within it. Among the founding fathers who contributed to establish sociology as an academic discipline, Imal Durkheim paid much attention to identify those social forces through which establish, maintain, amidst chaos in a changing society. Marx invested his academic caliber and identified the causes of those changes. He came to a conclusion that the conflict developed among the people from unequal distribution of economic resources. Economic resources is the major force to induce change in a given order of society. You know why? Weber focused his academic attention to justify that the scale of personal efforts put by individuals in their personal life play the major role to determine their economic, political, and social status. These scholars were inclined to interpret the processes involved in some forms of social relations by focusing their discussions on the feature of some specific kind of society. In subsequent times, some others also make it known that human society has multiple levels of expressions, Parsons or Western. Each level of society has its own constituent component, and each component of society has its own analytical significance. Given this multiple layers of expanse of the social relation, a society can take the form of global community and rank multiple layers up to the micro level of family units. Each scale of these social units is created and maintained by the constant interaction of its constituent elements. These elements can be individuals in micro scales of society and various forms of institutional units in macro scale society. This conceptual abstraction developed by the community of scholars through a long period of their economic engagement of the understanding the features of the different kinds of societies in the world are useful guiding principle for the analysis of working of our own society. There is, however, very limited efforts from the scholars of Nepal. Now I'm coming to Nepal. There is, however, very limited efforts. That is comprehension. From the scholars of Nepal to understand the structure and the process of Nepali society and the features of the constituent elements. It is in part due to very short span of time covered by the growth and expansion of academic institutions within our country. It is mainly also by reason that the social science interest in Nepal until mid-1970s was focused either on ethnography study, that was ke khanchan, ke lagaunchan, ke garchan bhanne ethnography study, of social communities or functionalist discussions of the role of state and political elites. A few scholars wish to critical stand in their discussion also limited their interest to the level of working of state institution and its political elite. After mid-70s, there appears some level of change in the academic tradition, only the former level. Some scholars started to involve into debates by locating the problems of common people in front of their discussions. This process was started from the level of effort invested by some foreign scholars, Seddon, who is here now, Blackie, 1980. Since the early 1980s, Nepali scholars are engaged much vigorous in this type of intellectual tradition. Mishra, Badachan, Ogur, Pandu. I don't hesitate to mention at this occasion that Professor Saitanya Mishra took leadership for more than 3 decades among the Nepali scholars to interpret the working of our society by following this intellectual path. He argues that human society, including our own, is differentiated and hierarchized into different layers of the social units, hierarchical follower. A scholar has the duty to interpret the working of society from the vantage point of experiences gained by people located at the bottom of this hierarchy. Of course, the working of any society have their own local context. It is, however, a part of the state and global society, and analysis of the problems and the potentials of local population remains incomplete unless they are understood by locating their position under this broader framework of social structure. At occasion, I myself found the opportunity to work with him as colleague in some academic institution, mainly SINAS and Central Department of Social Anthropology. He Justice Society or Social Institute Mamali Padang part time. Tegalamali Professor Mishra Bata
माफिले पढ्ने भएछ धेरै कुरो सोधेर अनि मैले चाहिँ यहाँ ट्रेनिङ गरेर पढाउने गर्थेँ वान आवाज एट सिनास त्यसले गर्दाखेरि मेरो एकाडेमिक क्यारियरमा प्रोफेसर दालजी हुनुहुन्छ प्रोफेसर मिश्र हुनुहुन्छ उहाँबाट मैले धेरै फिडब्याकहरू पाइरहेको अवस्था छ आई इन्टर इन दोज इन्स्टिट्युसन रिलेटेड लेट देम प्रोफेसर मिश्र म अलिक पछि पनि प्रवेश गरेँ एन्ड लेट देम क्वाइट अर्डिटली उहाँभन्दा म धेरै वर्ष अगाडि मैले छोडेँ अथवा 2000 मैले छोडेँ यो तपाईँहरूको लागि सबैलाई एउटा खुसीको कब्र हो कि हामीले जब संवैधानिक निकायमा नियुक्ति पाउँछौँ त्यो कन्स्टिट्युसनल बडी भन्यो कि एपोइन्टमेन्ट यु हेभ टु रिजाइन फ्रम द युनिभर्सिटिज 2000 मैले जब लोकसेवा सदस्य मैले नियुक्ति पाएँ त्यो पनि मैले आज 14-15 वर्षको मैले राजीनामा दिएर गएँ त्यसले गर्दा भविष्यमा गएर हाम्रो समाज साथीहरू लोकसेवाको सदस्यमा संवैधानिक निकायमा निर्वाचन आयोगमा अनि मानवमा जानुभयो भनेदेखि त्यो पोस्टलाई छोड्नुपर्छ त्यो दुईवटा ढुङ्गामा कहिले पनि सर्न हुँदैन त्यो कन्स्टिट्युसन डजन्ट एलो अस संविधानले हामीलाई दिँदैन त तपाईँले जान्नुहोस् भने मैले थाहा पाएँ आफ्टर द्याट राज्य पुनर्संरचना आयोगको अध्यक्षमा मैले नियुक्ति गर्यो यु नो वेल द्याट आज द चेयरपर्सन द हाई लेभल रजिस्ट्रेसन कमिसन तर काम गर्न दिएन कि गणेश गुरुङले दिने जातभात मान्दैन यो के खालको राज्य बनाउँछ भनेर के राजनीतिक पार्टीलाई दिने एकदम शङ्का उपसङ्ग गरे अनि यसलाई कामै गर्न नदिने है भनेर मलाई त्यो हाई लेभल कमिसन चाहिँ काम गर्न दिएन त्यो काम गर्न नदिएको पाप अहिले धुरीहरू कुरिरहेको छ त्यसैमा यो मुलुक अल्झिरहेको छ किनभने त्यो देखेर म सकिहाल्यो अनि पछिको आयोग भन्यो त्यो आयोगले के ल्याएको थियो 2 reports आर एभाइलेबल थियो दुईवटा प्रारम्भ गरे दुईवटा एउटाले एउटा राति एउटा 6 राज्य एउटा 10 राज्य अनि कुन कमिसनको रिपोर्टलाई तपाईँ मान्नुहुन्छ द्याट्स कन्फ्युजन होइन त्यो एकदम त्यसरी गएको हुनाले त्यसमा आफ्टर द्याट आई जोइन युनिभर्सिटी ग्रान्ट कमिसन एज चेयरपर्सन मलाई विश्वविद्यालय मन्त्रालयको अध्यक्षको रूपमा पठाएँ म फेरि त्यहाँ काम गरेर आएँ अहिले सिए मेम्बरको रूपमा त्यही संविधानको बारेमा स्टेटरी स्ट्रक्चरिङको बारेमा म गरिराख्नु पर्छ मैले भन्नै पर्छ तपाईँहरूलाई कि 10 सालको जस्तो स्टेट बलियो कुनै पनि ठाउँमा हुँदैन यो नेपालको समाज साथी मानव साथी र 48 सबैसम्म बहस गर्न तयार हुन्छ कि त्यहाँ हिमाल हुन्छ युल फाइन्ड हिमाल एर्सेगुम्बा गएर मधेसको साथीलाई थाहै थिएन वाट इज युज अफ एर्सेगुम्बा वाट इज इम्पोर्टेन्ट एर्सेगुम्बा कति पैसा पर्ने बल्ल आजकल थाहा पाउँदैछन् जब मान्छेहरू मर्न थाले अनि मिड लेभल हाम्रो मध्यपालिका तल तलैहरू छ धेरै जनशक्तिको भण्डार छ बिजुली बिजुली यति धेरै पैसा पाउनु चाहिँ नेपाली सबैजनाले पैसा पाउनु हुन सक्छौँ अनि तरै हाम्रो त्यो त अन्न भण्डार हो त्यसो पनि एउटा साइकोलोजी पनि हो कि एउटा जाने राष्ट्रियताको एउटा के भने हामी सबै नेपाली हौँ भन्ने भावना ल्याउने भएकोले मैले यो थर गोत्र वंश जातभावको कुरा गर्ने मान्छे होइन म नेसनल लेभलमा राज्यलाई कसरी बनाउने त्यो राज्य बलियो भनेदेखि त्यो पछाडि त चेपाङलाई पनि यो नयाँ चलामा घर बनाउन सकिन्छ नयाँ बनाउन सकिन्छ अथवा राउटर ल्याएर पनि लाजी पार्टमा घर बनाउन सकिन्छ अब पैसा हुन्छ भने पैसै छैन भने त्यो गरिब स्टेटहरू गरिब प्रदेशहरू मगन्ती भिगमका प्रदेशहरू वी डोन्ट निड भनेर पनि मैले भोइस गरे अवस्था म तपाईँहरूलाई बताउन चाहन्छु ओके आई इन्टर द इन्स्टिट्युसन लेफ्ट इन द्याट प्रोफेसर मिस एन्ड लेफ्ट यु क्वाइट अर्ली टु हिम आई फिल प्रिभिलेज द्याट आई एम किनभने स्पिकर तपाईँको साथी इन द अकेजन विच इन विच प्रोफेसर मिश्र इज अनर इन द फर्स्ट नेसनल कन्फरेन्स अर्गनाइज द कम्युनिटी अफ सोसियोलोजी नेपाल कन्ग्रेचुलेसन टु प्रोफेसर मिश्र ओके बिफोर कन्क्लुडिङ माई किनोट स्पिच काइन्डली लेट मी एक्सप्लेन ब्रिफ अन दि डिबेट अफ मेथोलोजी एन्ड द मेथड्स टु यो पनि ठुलो उसमा आइराखेको छ कि एज आई हेभ मेन्सन बिफोर द सोसियोलोजिस्ट अफ नेपाल हेभ टु अन्डरटेक द रेस्पोन्सिबिलिटी फर एक्सप्लोरेसन एन्ड एनालिसिस भेरी एस्पेक्ट्स अफ चेन्ज इन द सोसाइटी हाम्रो मुलुकमा जे जति परिवर्तनहरू आएको छ त्यसको तपाईँ यङ सोसियोलोजिस्टको हातमा छ अब कसरी तपाईँ अनुसन्धान गर्नुपर्छ भने एट दे टाइम यु टक अबाउट मेथड एन्ड मेथड्स यसरी हेर्दाखेरि द डिबेट अन सोसल साइन्सेस मेथोडोलोजिस एन्ड मेथड्स हेज बिन भेरी मच अलाइन्ड द एकाडेमिक डिस्कर्स इज हाइली डिभाइडेड अन द बेसिस अफ मेथड्स एन्ड मेथोडोलोजिकल नेचर स्कोप एन्ड एप्लिकेबिलिटी वेदर दिज वुड बी टाइम स्पेसिफिक एन्ड टाइम स्पेसिफिक अफ दि युनिभर्सल एन्ड इभर एप्लिकेबल द सोसल साइन्स मेथोडोलोजी बियोन्ड युनिभर्सल होमोजेनिटी क्रस द इम्बेडेड फिलोसफी कल्चर एन्ड कन्टेक्सुअल अर इन्टर पर्सनल ट्रान्जेक्सनल पर्सपेक्टिभ एन्ड relational mechanism across disciplines over time and space. Corbin and Strauss observe methodology is a way of thinking about the study of social phenomena. It seems true for many social scientists, for example, since many decades, two approaches. How? Why?
have been reckoning as a discourse, study following the structural function theory in America and the reaction upon our influences of Marxist philosophy in Europe, respectively, is good like that. Beyond positivist methodology school, current social science methodology debate, delving into as to whether social reality pre-exists or arises out of the interaction between the researcher and the research subject. On the other hand, the question of self-research is a crucial indicator for discourse in the social science research. Sociology focuses on modern society, as you know, with its departing values. However, yet we have to distinguish distinctive features of sociology. We have to distinguish, you know that. As anthropology studies, every not supposing a separate universe and a complete structure of the structure, but sociology focuses on inter and intra norms of comparison that Nepali sociology had to discover. Nepali sociology had to discover its own theory, own methodology to understand various forms of Nepali dynamism and dynamism. Once again, I repeat. Nepali sociology had to discover its own theory, own methodology to understand various forms of Nepali dynamism and dynamics. Thus, this is the right time to say that the young socialists of Nepal, young socialists have been a role to play carry for the academic tradition established by their seniors.
हामी जो सिनियर बनाउँदा छौँ हामी जे जे गर्नु काइन्डली यसलाई इम्प्रुभ गर्नुहोस् यसलाई अगाडि बढ्नुहोस्
यङ सोसलिस्ट हवर वदाउट हेजिटेसन दिस इज माई प्लेजर टु टेक अपर्च्युनिटी टु कन्भिन्स यु अल टु इन्फर्म यु अल द्याट प्रोफेसर मिश्र इज अ वर्स प्राइड जेनियस हि इज अवर एकाडेमिक लिडर फ्रम द फिल्ड अफ सोसियोलोजी एन्ड वी निड हिज गाइडेन्स Leadership, it is always appreciated. Professor Mira retired Nubal, but I am long ago than Maya Mamata Sadar Jelvin Sanger. Rayoda Kuramata Palamanju, Nepal Sarkarma, Sachi Pata retired Govandi, Volibola Kit Hansa Manuli, Prayogari, Prado Gari, Pajuru Gari, sub positions any. Only behind the Novaja Batan, the Kai Kai in the man. Hana Kavis Doros Rulamusa. अनि हो म त रिटायर सचिव हो बा के भयो होला भन्दै त्यो भौतरिएर बसमा चढेर पशुपनाथ पा कुदो रहेछ बसमा चढेर बट वी डोन्ट हेभ रिटायर लाइफ हाम्रो रिटायर लाइफ छैन हामीले रिटायर लाइफ किन छैन भनेदेखि मैले कतिपल्ट तपाईँले कान्तिपुरमा देख्नुभयो होला आत्महत्याको बारेमा लेख लेखेको छु मुलुकमा पाँचवटा राज्य हुनुपर्दछ नाइजेरियामा तिनवटा राज्य थियो सुरुमा 36 पुग्यो नेपाल पनि त्यस्तै हुनुपर्छ मैले लेखेर लेखेर तपाईँले देख्नुभयो होला राष्ट्रियको सवालमा पनि धेरै प्रश्न लेखिरहेको वी आर नेभर रिटायर तर प्रोफेसरले रिटायर भन्न मिल्दैन है अफिसियली होला केही खुम्चेर पढ्नु होला तर उहाँको लेखन कुराहरू अगाडि बढ्छ हाम्रो समाज साथी युवा भाइहरूलाई बहिनीहरूलाई माया गर्ने सुपरभिजन गर्ने अलिक ठरो नभइकन सर उहाँले भनिहाल्ने अलिकति जान्छ के त भने बुझ्ने भाषामा कहिलेकाहीँ उहाँको भाषा म पनि बुझ्दिनँ अठार अङ्ग्रेजी ल्याइदिनुहुन्छ बुझ्न नसकेर त्यो टिसाई पठाउनु पर्छ कहिलेकाहीँ त्यस्ता भाषामा होइन इट्स माई हम्बल रिक्वेस्ट सिम्पल ल्याङ्ग्वेजमा अझ नेपालीमा हाम्रो दिदीबहिनी आउँदाखेरि माया दिनुहोस् प्यारो दिनुहोस् ठरो ढङ्गले हामीसँग बोलिदिनु नबोलिदिनुहोस् माया दिनुहोस् न त अब तपाईँ बुढो भइसक्नु भएको होइन कपाल त्यसले गर्दा के त भने हामीले उहाँलाई बनाउनु छ तपाईँले नेपाललाई बनाउनु छ तपाईँले समाज शासनको अगाडि बढाउनु छ त्यसो भएकोले माई स्पेसल माई हम्बल रिक्वेस्ट प्रोफेसर मिश्र उहाँ सिम्पल हुनुहुन्छ हाई थिङ्किङ पनि हुनुहुन्छ सिम्पली हाई थिङ्किङ तर हाम्रो भाइ बहिनीहरूसँग सुपर लिनु क्रममा सो सोध्ने बेलामा समय दिनुहुन्छ प्रशस्त उहाँले तर अलिक बुझिने भाषा अलिक सरल तपाईँले बताइदिनु हो भने त्यो धेरै फाइदा हाम्रो भाइहरूले लिन्छन् भन्ने मैले एउटा अनुरोध गर्दै मैले निकै लामो समय लिएँ त्यसैले म तपाईँहरूको धेरै धन्यवाद छ र सबैजना नमस्कार फेरि आज पनि धन्यवाद